In this lesson, we'll review how to set up and trigger your emails, and we'll review how to send them manually in a separate video. To get started, click Settings, Emails. Now the emails are organized very similarly to the products and forms. Feel free to create your own categories, click Actions Order Categories to change the order, or click and drag emails to move them between categories. To create a new email, you would just click Create New Template to get started. But today, let's start by breaking down an existing template together. Now when you mouse over a template, you can see that there are three things you can do with an email. Clicking the pencil lets you change the title of the template. Clicking Edit Text lets you change the content or subject of the email. And clicking Trigger lets you set it up to send out automatically. Let's start by clicking the pencil. Here, you can change the name of the template, and keep in mind that the name of the template doesn't have to be the subject of the email, so feel free to name it whatever would be most helpful. Next, let's click Edit Text. Feel free to adjust the subject if you want it to be different from the template name. Up across the top, you'll see your standard text editing is there. Hyperlinks, text formatting, and even the source if you're comfortable with using HTML. Apart from the basics, a cool feature of emails is that tokens can pull any information from the system and display it. These are those purple fields you see. To add a token, click Token up at the top. You'll be confronted with a list of your user's forms, plus a special location called System Fields. While adding tokens from the user's forms is pretty straightforward, the System Fields provide unique information about a user and can be really useful. Now, because you have a family system, you'll have a parent and child version of the system fields. Clicking the parent system fields will let you include family-level information, which will accumulate information from all of the sub-users. Some highlights include list of all payments made by family or organization, and the family cart list. In the child system fields, you can include child-specific information, and some of the highlights here include child or subunit cart list, and list of all child or subunit forms. Incomplete forms appear in red, and completed forms appear in green. Once you've added your tokens, you can click View Example to see how it'll look at a glance, or send an example email to yourself. Now there's something important you need to know about tokens. If a token is pulled for a user who did not answer the question, not only will the token not appear, but any adjacent text will be removed as well. Allow me to demonstrate. If this user had not ordered any products, then it might be odd to get an email that just said order. But by erasing adjacent text, they would just get a friendly reminder, and it would not appear that any mistake had been made. So make sure to space out your emails to ensure that a missed token doesn't have unintended consequences. Otherwise, click Save and Return to Message Management when you're done. Next, let's go ahead and trigger the email, in case you wanted to send it out automatically. First, choose a Send From address. Do you see that email in the middle? This is called a system email, and if configured, will become a Send To or From option for any of your admins. To get this set up, contact our support team and let them know what the system email should be. Next, choose a Send To address. This can be any email field which was included on a form, and you can CC yourself or an admin as well. The Send Only Once box at the bottom will be checked by default, but you can uncheck it if you want an email to go out every time the trigger conditions are satisfied. Otherwise, it'll only go out the first time they satisfy the conditions. Next, you need to set the trigger conditions. The most common trigger for automatic emails is when child forms are complete, and you would add the completed option for each form that each child must fill out. Otherwise, feel free to set your own triggers, and click That's It when you're done. Once you've finished, you can review your triggers at any time by clicking the lightning bolt icon. Hope this helps. And feel free to contact our support team if you have any questions. And as always, thanks for watching.